Hey everyone, my name's Dom. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the study. This is where I go when I invite you to take a deeper look at some of the books in the series that I'm reading, or when it's a more involved tag so that I don't have to come away from the computer and write down a load of questions to answer and so forth. So today we're going to take a look at some of the series that I'm in the middle of reading and also some of the series that I want to be in the middle of reading. So stay tuned to see where we're at. So keeping track of the series that I'm reading isn't something that I generally tend to do, but I've started to keep an eye on it just in terms of the reading stats that I'm producing on a monthly basis for my own benefit, and I'll also include some of those in my reading wrap-ups as we go along, starting with my recent August review. So when I first started taking a look at the actual series I'm in the middle of, I was looking at series that I essentially haven't DNF'd. So whether it's a series that I really want to carry on with, I kind of want to carry on with, or that I'm really just not sure. I haven't actually DNF'd the series yet, so I've included it in my list. And there are a total, if I've not missed any out, of 17 series within that collection. So what I'm going to do today is just take a look at them in terms of what the books are, how far through the series I am compared to how many books there are in the series. And I'm also going to collect them into three groups. So one is the definitely want to continue. One is the I do really want to continue, but I just really don't know when I'm going to get round to it. So they're the ones that I'm not quite as excited for. And then the third and final category in these is the ones that I'm really not sure about. It's kind of a what you might call a soft DNF at the moment. I've kind of given up on the series, but I might yet go back and do more. Once we're through with those, I'm going to take a quick look as well at some of the series that I really want to be in the middle of. So ones that I'm really excited to start and that I hope to add to this ongoing list in the coming months. Now I've got the computer in front of me with Goodreads locked and loaded, so let's just start at the top and go through some of these series. So the first one in the definitely want to continue is Threadlight by Zach Argyle. Now I read Voice of War just a month or two ago and I really enjoyed it. It was a 4-star read for me. I really liked the world, I liked the characters. More than that, I really liked the way the characters were written, the way that they integrated within this world, but most of all the way that they kind of felt and reacted to each other. I thought it was really well done. I thought it was something that you don't really see explored as much as we explored it in Voice of War. I don't know when book three is going to be released, but this is slated to be a trilogy and I'm really looking forward to continuing the series by reading Stones of Light, but also for when that third book comes out, I'm sure that I'm going to be buying that one as well. So Threadlight definitely takes its spot towards the top of the list of books that I really want to continue with the series for, and although there's only the one book left for me to read at the moment, hopefully it's not going to be too long before I can add a third book into that collection as well. Up next, and continuing with the series that I'm really excited to continue with, this is a completed trilogy, and you can see I've got a collection of books just here. And the first one of these is the Lycanius trilogy by James Islington. I've read book one, The Shadow of What Was Lost. Again, it was quite a recent read. I really enjoyed it. It was another 4-star read for me. And I said in my review video for this that if books two and three continue as book one did, this is one that I can definitely see breaking into my top 10 fantasy reads. So really excited for this one and want to continue pretty much as soon as possible with this. Now the story for Lycanius, I've heard some people say it's a little bit YA, and I know at least one person who DNF'd the series partway through book one because of that, but when I was reading it I didn't really see that. It starts out in a school setting but we don't spend a lot of time there, and we've got young characters, but I don't think that qualifies it as being YA. The book didn't read as a YA series for me, or a YA book. For me, it's more along the lines of something like The Wheel of Time, where it's definitely an adult fantasy rather than a YA fantasy. It's just that the main characters, at least, are a little bit younger. They're in their late teens, but it's not got kind of the normal themes that you tend to associate with young adult books. And also the writing as well is definitely, for me, geared more towards an adult audience. Next up on the list, and the third of the three series that I'm really the most excited about continuing on, is The Farseer by Robin Hobb. Next up on my list is Royal Assassin. So I read Assassin's Apprentice. I've spoken about it a few times, including, of course, in my dedicated review video for the book. But I really enjoyed it, even if the start was, for me, a little bit on the slow side. I really liked the ending, where the action kind of really ramped up and the book started to get quite a good bit of intensity. And I liked what it was setting up for the continuation of the series, both in terms of The Farseer and potentially beyond The Farseer in the wider realm of the Elderlings. So I know that if I do continue to enjoy this series, there are several more series within this kind of wider realm that I'm going to be looking forward to reading as well. So continuing then with the series that I definitely want to read more of, next up on the list is The Expanse by James S.A. Corey. So with this one, I've only read book one, Leviathan Wakes, but I've got several more of the books on my Kindle, including a couple of the novellas, which I'm not sure whether I'm going to go for them or not, but I definitely want to continue with the main story. I did enjoy the book. It was quite a while ago that I read it, but I definitely did like it. Now, with this one, I did watch the TV show first, so I knew the general kind of gist of the plot. I knew the characters and the setting and so forth. But obviously, you get a lot more through the book than you do just from a TV show. I really enjoyed the TV show. It's one of my favourite series that I've seen in recent years, and I'm hoping that the books are going to continue with that. And it's quite a nice one as well, because I know that if I do continue to enjoy these, there's a good bit more of this world for me to explore with the, is it the ninth book and final book to be released later on this year. Next up on the list, and I've been to my little collection of books again, because this one is another one that I own the books for. It's the Stormlight Archive by Brandon Sanderson. I have read The Way of Kings. Again, it was several years ago that I read this, and I just haven't got round to reading the next book in the series. So I do have the split volumes of Words of Radiance, and I am looking forward to reading them. I do find that where I do most of my reading on the Kindle, if I do have a physical copy of a book, I think that makes me more likely to actually get round to it, which is what we'll see later on in this list as well. Whereas if I've just got the Kindle, or if I haven't actually purchased it yet, the books and the series are more likely, I would say, to kind of fall by the wayside, almost get forgotten about, really. So having these ones does make it more likely that I'm going to get to them, but I have actually set myself a target of continuing with the series and at least starting, if not finishing, Words of Radiance this year. That is a target that I set myself, along with another kind of bunch of books that I was in the middle of the series for earlier in the year. And I've done a few of those series, finished one, maybe two of them, DNF'd a couple, and we've got another couple of those series to be covered in this video. So Stormlight Archive is one of those. It is one that I fully intend to continue on with, and we'll see how Words of Radiance goes. I did like The Way of Kings. Looking at this, I rated it 5 stars, so although I can't remember a vast amount of it, and I'm going to have to go for a bit of a reminder of what happens in the book and who the characters are and what the setting is and so forth, I definitely did enjoy it, and I am looking forward to going back to it. But I guess it's quite a hefty chunk, even in the two volumes here. We're talking sort of 500-600 pages for each of these, so I suppose it's really a bit daunting, and it's a case of trying to fit in such a big book. Even if I do take the option of splitting them and reading them separately with the break in between, which is not something that I did with The Way of Kings, and it's not something that I intend to do with Words of Radiance, but we'll see how it goes when I get there. And then next up, we've got a couple of series that I don't have physical copies for. The first of these is a series called Tyrus Rex, Contracts and Terminations. If you saw my recent video on the 10 best books that I've read according to everyone else on Goodreads, I'll link it up in the cards above. One of the surprises on there was a book called Retribution, which was book 9, I think it was, in the Galaxy's Edge series by Jason Anspach and Nick Cole. Tyrus Rex is one of the characters who pops up in that series, and this is kind of a prequel series. It's set before the events of those 10 books that make up the Galaxy's Edge series. Tyrus Rex is a kind of a legendary bounty hunter, and the 3 books of the series deal with specific jobs and specific contracts that he had earlier on in his career that kind of helped to make him a legend. So I've read the first 2 books in the series. That's Requiem for Medusa and Chasing the Dragon, rated 4 stars and 3 stars respectively for those two. And then we've got Madame Guillotine as the third book, which I've not gotten hold of yet. I do quite like this series, and I find the characters and the setting quite interesting. And I do want to finish this one relatively quickly because it's the last book in a series. There are several other series within this world and with some of these characters to go on to next. And I've got some of those in my list for a future read, basically. But Madame Guillotine is next on the list for the Tyrus Rex Contracts and Termination series for me to pick up. So next up in the list of books that I do want to continue the series for, but I'm not sure when I'm going to get round to them, is going to The World of Shannara by Terry Brooks. The Heritage of Shannara is the series that I'm in the middle of. So I read the first book, which is The Scions of Shannara, and to be honest, I didn't really like it. After quite enjoying the previous books, having a good time with them, this one, I just couldn't get along with pretty much most of the characters, and one of the characters who I particularly didn't get along with is Walker Bow. And the next book in the series, The Druid of Shannara, is one that focuses more so on Walker Bow, and that's probably more than anything why I haven't continued with the series so far. So prior to this, the Shannara books have kind of been set in their own timeline, or at least each book is set kind of a good bit of time after the preceding book, so you get a different bunch of characters each time you pick up a new Shannara book. So the Heritage of Shannara series is kind of the first one really where we're dealing with a continuation in terms of the actual characters. We've not had a good period of time passing in between the books and so forth. So there's a little bit of a difference then. I do normally prefer that because I like to get embedded with the characters and the ongoing storyline, but when it's a set of characters that you're not so keen on, then it can work in the opposite direction as well. So that's what I'm finding here. But I've got the Druid, the Elf Queen, and the Talismans of Shannara. And again, like with other series, if I do enjoy the continuing series here, there are plenty of other books to go in different series in this, in the wider Shannara world. And I do have some of these on my bookshelf from when I was collecting books as part of a book club previously, where I picked up loads of books that I wasn't already familiar with. And for many of these, I still haven't read yet. Some of them I've unhauled and some of them I'm keeping on the shelves because I do at some point hope to get to them. Okay, so with Shannara out of the way, we go back to another classic, and this one is Neverwinter, or the classic, I guess, really is the Forgotten Realms and R.A. Salvatore's Tales of Dritzdoerden. So I've said in previous videos, he's probably one of my favourite, if not my favourite, character in fantasy fiction, and I did quite enjoy Gaunt or Grim, which is the first book in the Neverwinter series. This one, actually titled Neverwinter, is book two. And then we've got Charon's Claw and The Last Threshold to come later down the line as well. Now, this is one of those examples where there are so many books in the kind of wider series that you're always going to get some that are good and some that are not so good. And sometimes the storylines can get a little bit stale because there's only so far you can go with a core group of characters. With this one, some of the characters are really long-lived and some of them aren't, so you do get a bit of change up in the general groups of characters that you see. You've got some who are there for kind of a long haul and then some who come and go because their lifespans are kind of more like human lifespans as opposed to the long-lived dwarves and elves and so forth. So with this one, I did quite like Gaunt or Grim. I did rate it 4-star, and if I'm being totally honest with you, I can't really remember a lot about it. So this, like with many of these, where there's been a good amount of time in between reading the books, I'm going to have to do a little bit of reminding myself what happened in the previous books in the series before I continue with the next book. Next, we move on to another book that I've acquired recently. This one is The Triumph of the Dwarfs by Marcus Heitz. The Dwarfs series, I actually really liked book one. I thought it was really decent and really enjoyable. The follow-up books in the series were good, but they didn't quite live up to the first one. They weren't as good as book one in the series, which was just called The Dwarves. So this one is book five in the series. So I have read The War of the Dwarves, Revenge of the Dwarves, Fate of the Dwarves, and obviously just The Dwarves itself. And The Triumph of the Dwarves is book five. This one's got a higher rating on Goodreads than actually all of them. With books 1 through to 5, we're dealing 3.95, 4.07, 4 flat, 3.96, and then this one is 4.13. So I'm hoping that when I do get around to this one, I agree with the general Goodreads populace and really enjoy it. So we'll see how this one goes. And then following on from the dwarves, I've got another Marcus Hite series, which is the Legends of the Elfar, which is, they're kind of the dark elves who work on the opposite side, if you like, of the dwarves from the previous series. This one, I've read the first book, which is Righteous Fury. There's then, if I get them the right way around, we've got Devastating Hate and Dark Paths to continue with the series. This one, again, similarly to the dwarves, the later books do have a higher average rating. So Righteous Anger is translated as Righteous Anger on Goodreads, my book. If I can get it off the shelf. First book is actually translated in the book itself as Righteous Fury. But this one was rated 3.98, and I kind of agreed with that. I gave it a 4-star rating, so I do really like this world. And then books 2 and 3 on here have got a 4 and a 4.13. So hopefully, again, they're going to be a good continuation. I wasn't as sold. I didn't like this one as much as the Dwarf series, but the overall writing style, the overall story and the world and so forth, I've been really intrigued by and quite enjoying my time there. And then the final book series that I do want to continue, but I don't know when I'm going to get around to it, is the Copper Cat series by Jen Williams. I've read book one, which is A Copper Promise. So this was actually her debut novel. She started off with four kind of web novellas, if you like, which were then pulled together into this book. And I just saw it on a shelf one day and quite liked it, because the cover itself maybe doesn't stand out quite so much, but when you turn it on the spine, it got a really nice verdigris there, and it does stand out nicely. Nice bit of contrast there, but it does really stand out on a bookshelf. So the four books that made up The Copper Promise were Ghosts of the Citadel, Children of the Fog, Prince of Wounds, and Upon the Ashen Blade. So they're all contained within this volume. Because they were pulled together from four individual stories, the story itself for The Copper Promise is a bit jumpy. It's a bit kind of jarring almost when one of those stories finishes and the next one starts. And I'm hoping that that's just kind of a one-off because of the way this was set up. And then you've got book two is The Iron Ghost, which I do have on my Kindle, and book three is The Silver Tide. Both of those have got a higher rating, going from 3.64 for The Copper Promise. I gave it a 3-star rating. You've then got 4.13 for book two and 4.26 for book three. So that's really hopeful for the continuation of the series. And I do want to get to this at some point because I did quite enjoy the premise of it. I also want to read more of Jen Williams because I know a lot of people really go on about her Winnowing Flame trilogy, which starts with The Ninth Rain. And I know, for instance, Adrian from All Booked Up, I'll link down below, he's done a video which is kind of a why you should read this series. I haven't watched the video because I do want to read the series. I don't need to be convinced. But I do really want to continue, I think, with the Copper Cat trilogy before I move on to her next one. Okay, so now I'm moving on to the books where I'm not sure, I'm not sold yet on the series, and I don't know whether I want to continue with the series or not. So we're going to start off with one of my recent reads. I read a review copy of The Last Watch by J.S. Dewes recently, and the second book in the series, The Exiled Fleet, has also just recently been released. I did like The Last Watch. It's a sci-fi book which is kind of reminiscent a bit of Battlestar Galactica, at least in the start of the book, where you've got kind of a museum of a ship and you've got this threat which is on the horizon, and they can't really deal with it because the ship isn't built for it, or at least it's not being maintained for any kind of battle or even travel, to be honest. So that throws various kind of spanners in the works as the story goes on. With this one, I did like the premise, I did like the general idea, most of the setting and so forth, but what I didn't like was the characters. So you've got this exiled prince called Cavalon Mercer, and he's sent to this, essentially, museum ship at the edge of the universe under the command of Adequin Rake. So Adequin Rake is a military hero. She's been promoted several rungs up the ladder to get this command of this particular ship, and they're basically watching out for an ancient threat at the edge of the universe. Although Cavalon Mercer is, by the synopsis on the back of the book, an arsehole, it's the way that he's written. He's specifically supposed to be like that. And I get the idea through what he does and the interactions he has with the other characters that he's supposed to kind of win you over and bring you around to liking him. And that just never worked for me. I didn't like him at all from the start of the book to the end of the book. The main thing that I didn't like with regards to Ada Quinn Wray, she's a career soldier and she's high ranked in the military and she just lets him get away with anything, whereas if that was in kind of real life, so to speak, she'd be shouting at him all the time, tearing him a new one. He'd be in the brig at various points for some of the things that he does. And yeah, she just lets him get away with it. And then you end up basically with him coming to save the day. So he spends most of the book being completely inept and people are wondering why he's there because he can't do anything. And then when you've got a life or death situation, he's suddenly the cleverest person on the ship, even though you've already been introduced to people who are absolute geniuses. He will still be the one who comes up with all the answers instead of those geniuses. And it just didn't work for me. It wasn't believable enough. And by doing it that way, you really pushed some of these side characters too far to the side, where I thought it would have been a lot better to incorporate them and have them give more input to what was going on and so forth. So overall, I liked the book, but not really the characters, or at least the kind of the main couple of characters and their interactions with each other. But at the same time, I do kind of like what's going on. I do like the general premise of the story. So I'm kind of in two minds whether to carry on and to read The Exiled Fleet or whether to just write this one off as a lost cause and forget that the series ever existed. Next up, we're going back to Daniel Abraham, who is one half of the two authors writing the Expanse series as James S.A. Corey. I read The Dragon's Path, book one of The Dagger and the Coin, several years ago. It was different, but I quite enjoyed it, and I've rated it according to Goodreads as 4 stars, so I obviously enjoyed it. I've just never got round to continuing with this series. So we've got 5 books here: King's Blood, Tyrant's Law, Widow's House, and The Spider's War. And Dragon's Path started it off quite nicely. I seem to remember that there was a couple of characters again who I wasn't quite sure about, and I wasn't quite sure of the way it was working. There was a bit of a kind of a subtle time jump in this book as well, if I remember correctly. So that kind of threw me a little bit, and that was maybe one of the things that I didn't like as much. The series itself is one of those that I don't think is as well read. So with this one in particular, if you've read it, let me know what you thought of the overall series and help me to make up my mind whether I should continue with this one or whether I should DNF the series. And the next one is one of the ones that I'm probably closer to DNFing because I just cannot persuade myself to continue with this series, even though in many ways I really want to. Probably the main reason that I really want to, or 2 reasons, I guess. One, this was at one point one of my favourite series. And 2, it's a 5-book series and I've read 4, so there's only 1 book left to go. This is The Demon Cycle by Peter V. Brett. I read The Warded Man, or as it is in the UK, The Painted Man, when it came out, and I really loved it. It was a 5-star read for me. Really enjoyed it, and I listed it as one of my favourite books and the beginning of one of my favourite series. 2nd book in the series is The Desert Spear, which I also rated 5 stars, so I obviously enjoyed that, even if by memory I didn't enjoy it nearly as much. 3rd book, The Daylight War, is where it started to go wrong for me. We spent book one with a character who I really enjoyed, was really interesting. Book two, we focused on him, but he started to fade into the background a little bit compared to a new character who we'd heard a little bit about in book one, but it was still okay. Book three, we again took a side character from the 2nd book and we focused. It was a big book, a big thick book, and the first half of the book was basically her backstory, and it completely lost me. It took me too far away from the story that I was enjoying, and I just couldn't get on with it. I rated it 3 stars, but I really just didn't enjoy it, especially compared to the other books in the series. Book 4 then was The Skull Throne, which was another 3-star read for me, because by this point I think I'd just kind of lost interest a bit with the series and was already maybe thinking, I don't know if I'm going to continue and finish the series as a whole. And then book five is where I'm up to, and that is The Core. So in terms of the ratings, let's have a look here. So we've got The Painted Man or The Warded Man, 4.23. Desert Spear, 4.18. The Daylight War, surprisingly for me, is rated higher at 4.21. And then you've got 4.14 for The Skull Throne, and then The Core is 4.17. So these are all kind of really in the same range, even though for me they definitely weren't. Now, as I say, I really enjoyed this series before the last couple of books came out, at least. And I do have this lovely addition to the series, The Great Bazaar, which is a nice signed copy from the author, one of the special Subterranean Press editions. So if I do decide that I'm not going to continue with this series, maybe there's a nice prize for someone here if I decide that I'm going to unhaul these books. Okay, so moving on, and we've got an author who at one point I would have counted as one of my favourites, and that is Michael J. Sullivan. So I've said plenty of times before that I really like and consider actually as one of my top 10 reads the Rhaera Revelation series, Theft of Swords, Rise of Empire and Heir of Novron. The series that introduces the characters Royce and Hadrian is the Rhaera Chronicles. So we've got the Crown Tower and the Rose and Thorn, which I own, and then we've also got the Death of Dolgath and the Disappearance of Winter's Daughter. So plenty to get my teeth into if I continue with this, but although this is book one in the series and I haven't read it, I'm going to treat it as a continuation for purposes of this video, because I did start this book. I do still have a bookmark in there, actually. Nice little train ticket. Page 178 of, what have we got here? It's about 375. There's a glossary in the back there, 368. So I've only got sort of 200 pages left to go in this one. I'm roughly halfway through there, but I just want to get on with it. I love the characters Royce and Hadrian, and this book is basically dealing with how they met and how they started working together in the kind of corporation, if you like, that they named Rhaera. So I know that I like the writing style, I know that I like the characters, but for some reason I just couldn't get on with it. And because of how I feel about Rhaera Revelations, my assumption for this one is that I just wasn't in the right frame of mind when I was reading The Crown Tower, and maybe I just needed a break and needed a palate cleanser and to come back to it at another time. Because there are so many books that I really want to read, though, that other time just hasn't come upon me yet. So maybe one day we'll get to it. But one thing that I did do recently was read Nolan, which was a review copy of the start of a new series set even further back in the history of this world. So we're not dealing with any of the characters, but we are dealing with the world and the history of it. And I really found issues with Nolan. So that's kind of really thrown me now, and I'm starting to think that maybe Rhaera Revelations was a bit of an anomaly, and I really enjoyed that one, but not the rest of Sullivan's works. But at some point, I will go back and try to finish or start again The Crown Tower. Okay, so another series that I started many, many, many years ago and haven't continued with for a good number of years since is Green Rider by Kristen Britton. So I read Green Rider itself and First Rider's Call. I then read book three, High King's Tomb. All of these I quite like. I gave 3-star ratings to books two and three and a 4-star to book one in the series. There are 6 books and a novella out at the moment, and then there is book 7 coming out sometime this year. And I think it might be book 8 is the final. So once Winterlight book 7 is released, there's one more to finish off this series. So I'm kind of thinking that this long-running series, the first book was 1998, I think it was published in. Why am I thinking that? I can check it. Yep, 1998. So it's a long-running series, bearing in mind that there's only 8 actual books in the series and 2 of those haven't been published yet. But because it is coming towards its end, that's maybe another reason for me to continue with this series and get it finished, rather than having a series where I'm waiting for the next book to be released and I'm all fully caught up with it. So I don't know yet whether I'm going to continue. I did quite like it, but I don't know if I liked it enough to give it priority over some of the other books that I really want to be getting to. And then last on my list of series that I'm in the middle of, and with these ones I'm not sure whether I'm going to continue, is Drakenfeld by Mark Charan Newton. This one I've had for years. It was published in 2013, and I picked up a review copy from the author. So that's really nice of the author to have done that. I really appreciated it, and I really appreciated the book as well. I've rated it 4 stars. It's only got a 3.5 star average rating, so it's one of the lower rated books in terms of the general Goodreads populace, but that doesn't matter because everyone's got their own opinions, and my opinion is that 3.5 is a little bit too low for this book. I did really enjoy it. It was very different for me. It's a kind of a murder mystery in a fantasy setting, so not something that I've read a lot of. The murder mystery itself was quite a clever one. It's a closed door kind of murder, and then there's a second mystery that comes along in the second part of the book as well, so plenty to keep you on your toes. I did quite like it. The characters, although it was several years ago, so I can't remember a vast amount of it, I think the characters were okay, but nothing special. But a book like this, you're really, as far as I'm concerned at least, you're really reading it for the mystery and for the cleverness of what happens in the story. And it definitely hit all the right notes as far as that goes. So I think there's only one other book released there. It's kind of a duology, and then there's a novella as well. This one, book two, is called Retribution. It's a bit higher rated, 3.99. And it's continuing with this officer of the Sun Chamber called Lucan Drakenfeld. So I'm kind of intrigued to see if he can do what he did in this one, Charan Newton, and give me a book that I'm going to enjoy and find really clever, because I do like to be tested and to really try and figure things out for myself and see how wrong or even how right I can be with that. And I really appreciate when a clever book comes along like that. And in fantasy, to be honest, it's not the main aim, so you don't tend to get them maybe as often as you do in some other genres. So again, only one book that I need to continue with the series, but I just don't know, with everything else that I've got on my plate books wise, whether I'm going to get to it at any point or not. Hey all, Editing Dom here. I've come from the future to save you from the other guy, because he talks way too much. The original plan had been to carry on now and talk about the series that I want to be starting, but I'm going to cut it here and follow up with part 2 on Monday. If you've made it this far through the video, well done. Give yourself a gold star. Go get yourself a drink. You probably need one after watching that. But if you did like the video, give it a thumbs up. Hit subscribe if you haven't already done so. Also, don't forget to drop a comment down below if you've read any of these series, especially the ones towards the end of the video where Dom from the current timeline isn't sure whether to continue with the series or not. I'll hopefully catch you in part 2 of this video in a few days' time, but until then, stay safe, take care of yourself, don't trust the machines. Bye.